I'm Miss McGeehin, the art teacher at Wallace. I hope everybody's feeling good, feeling healthy, but I really miss you guys, so I wanted to do a little drawing video for us to do together. Today I'm going to show you how to make a hungry fish. So you see, it's just a happy little fish swimming around, but I'm telling you, he is hungry! I think this is really fun. So if you want to do it with me, I'm going to show you step by step how to make a hungry fish like this. With these videos, you can pause it whenever I go a little too quick so you can catch up. There's no rush. This is just for fun, just to get those creative juices flowing while we're at home. All right, so I'm going to show you how to do this. All right, friends. So all you need for this project is a piece of paper, something to write with. I'm using a pencil because I like to have the option to erase if needed. Later, I'm going to go over the lines with a Sharpie and color in with colored pencils. You can use whatever materials you want, whatever you have, and we're going to go ahead and get started. But I also want to point out I have this underneath my piece of paper so that, one, I can keep my table clean and so that I make sure I have a nice smooth surface that I'm working on. All right, so first I'm going to show you how we fold the paper so that you can have that surprise hungry fish. First, all you gotta do is fold it in half. Make sure those corners line up at the bottom, and then you can get that crease. Simple. Then I'm gonna go ahead and take the top flap and bring it up to the crease. That's it. Then you have the paper that will open up for a surprise inside. Now I'm going to show you the step-by-step drawings, and remember, whenever you need to pause it, no problem. Take your time, be creative, have fun. So first step is just a straight line on the side here. I'm not all the way at the top. I'm a little bit down, and I go straight, and again, I don't go all the way to the bottom, but it's still a pretty long line. Then I'm going to do a diagonal line towards the middle, but I don't go all the way to the crease. I do the same thing on the bottom. And there you have the fish's tail. Then I'm gonna use a big curve line to make the fish's body, going up and around. And when I get to the front of the fish here, that line will go all the way to the crease. Same thing on the bottom. And there you have the fish's body. Next, I'm going to add my fins, a little one on the bottom, and a longer one on top. Then I'm going to add the fish's eye, just a circle right here, and a little circle inside. Then I'm going to add a small smile here, not too big, because we are going to add that big mouth when we open the paper up. Then I'm going to use a curved line like the letter C right there to kind of separate the fish face from the fish body. And that's where I'll start using lines to make my scales. Now, your scales do not have to look like mine. I like to do mine with big bumps, going all the way across the body. Then I'm going to add some little details in the fins. Now we have a happy fish. When we open them up, we're going to make them look really hungry. So what we need to do is get these lines connected. First, the straight line on the edge, then a big curve right here. Big mouth. And then we got to connect that line as well. There you go. Now I'm gonna give my fish really sharp, big teeth. Yikes. He's hungry. And now we just need to finish those details, bring those details through the fish body. Oh no. Now I'm gonna add whatever little details I want. I'm gonna make some seaweed on the bottom. You don't have to do the same things as me here. You can think what else might be around this fish. Maybe a snail, maybe a little crab coming in to give him a pinch. Maybe instead of eating something, he's instead screaming from a little crab pinching his tail. Whatever you want. I'm gonna draw some little fish that he's about to eat. Oh no. Maybe a couple bubbles. And there we go. All done with our drawing. Now I'm gonna go ahead, use my Sharpie to go over my lines. If you are using Sharpie, again, make sure you have something under your paper so you can keep your table safe. There we go. Now we have our happy fish, hungry fish. This cracks me up. All right, and now I'm gonna go ahead and color it. You do not have to color it the same way I do. Color it however you like. Be creative. Well, there we go, guys. We've got a happy, hungry fish. All right, friends, thank you so much for joining me today. Thank you for taking time in your day to be creative. Stay safe, be well, and I'll see you soon. Bye.